myself in the unfortunate situation of having to chase after Eleanor Roosevelt through city streets and back alleys, over rooftops and through tenement basements, abandoned buildings, and out into the country through swamps and bogs, cornfields, cow pastures, farmland, rivers, streams, mountains, valleys. She ran like the wind, and I never could quite catch up to her, though she was only a short distance ahead of me throughout the ordeal. Occasionally, she would look back and taunt me. She had legs like a racehorse and an unattractive black old lady shoes, and stockings that fell down around her ankles as she ran, but they didn't hinder her powerful stride or slow her down whatsoever. She wore a conservative, bland gray dress which hung on her like a sack, and although the world we ran through was full of color, Eleanor appeared to me only in black and white, like a crackled old newsprint photograph. She had arms which resembled octopus or giant squid tentacles, and they flopped from side to side as she ran and had a will of their own. Her head appeared to me as a rotten potato with tendrils and pale yellow shoots branching out and reaching for some dirt or rich black loam to suck nutrients from. Try as I may, I couldn't catch her, and as she ran, she sprayed herself with a beautiful antique gold perfume atomizer with an intoxicating cologne that smelled to me like jasmine or opium smoke. She vaulted over a fence and snagged her stockings on a rusty barbed wire, which broke off a piece of dry rot wood post. But it didn't slow her down as she sprinted to a field, dragging the fence post behind her, her tentacles flapping and her rotten potato head mocking my inability to catch her. She doused herself with perfume from her antique gold atomizer. Occasionally she would sing a tune which was vaguely familiar to me, but I could never quite place just where I'd heard it before. Been a long time since I rock and roll, been a long time since I did the stroll. Let me get back, let me get back, let me get back, baby, where I come from. She sang as she crashed through the plate glass window of a bodega and ran to the back, knocking over racks of snack foods, Hostess cakes, Wise potato chips, out the back and into the alley where I finally lost her as her stride increased and I fell into a state of exhaustion and was set upon by the panic store clerks who attempted to hold me responsible for the damage and clubbed me with iron rods and wooden bats. I should clarify at this point that the sole reason for me to be chasing after Eleanor Roosevelt was a compulsive desire to sit next to her on a comfortable overstuffed couch and cuddle with her like a benevolent grandmother, enveloped in a cloud of her intoxicating opium smoke perfume as she told me what a good boy I was. And all of my worldly troubles would become a vague memory, and I would be at peace with myself, and I wouldn't be bothered or concerned despite her tentacles or rotten potato head or torn stockings or the fact that she was snared in barbed wire and broken fence post. It became apparent to me that I would need to seek some help in regards to this situation, so I joined a support group of people experiencing the same dilemma as myself. We met at a local church meeting hall on Tuesday at 8 o'clock. We sat in a circle with folded chairs and drank black coffee. There was a small table with some cookies and donuts. The group moderator was an elderly gentleman who seemed a bit disinterested in our discussion, as if he had been doing this for too long and had heard too many Eleanor Roosevelt tentacle arms, rotten potato head chasing stories before. As the group took turns speaking, it became apparent to me that the members were all relating their experiences exactly as I have described my own experience. However, they all referred to their situation as a reoccurring dream or a delusion that they could not rid themselves of. When my turn came to speak, I expressed my concern that I didn't think this support group could be of any help to me, because I was not, in fact, dreaming or delusional about the situation. My particular problem was specifically in regards to the fact that this persistently and continually actually did happen to me, and I was growing weary of having to chase Eleanor Roosevelt with her torn stockings and old lady shoes and frumpy gray sack dress, and octopus tentacle arms and rotten potato heads sprouting pale yellow tendrils, entangled in barbed wire and broken fence posts, and spraying herself with the gold opium perfume atomizer in reality. And if I could just catch her and cuddle on an old couch with her like a loving and caring grandmother, the problem would cease to exist. But she was just too fast to catch. The befuddled group moderator thought silently for a few moments, checked his notes. Then he informed me that the support group for people in which this actually and continually did happen in reality met on Friday nights at 6 o'clock in the basement meeting room at the library on Oak Street.